Hi there, welcome to part two of the video series, Telescope Basics. My name is David Fuller, host of the Eyes on the Sky weekly stargazing series that can be found at eyesonthesky.com. In this video, I will explain how magnification and focal ratio work in amateur telescopes. Take a look at these three amateur telescopes. It may not appear so at first, but all three are actually the same size.
I want this host fired.
No, really, let's take a closer look. These two telescopes have similar sized lenses. This one is 76 millimeters and this one is 70 millimeters. This short reflector has a mirror of 76 millimeters, so they are all within 6 millimeters, or about a quarter of an inch in diameter of each other. So why does that matter? Well, when we talk about how powerful a telescope is, or can be, what we really mean is how much light it gathers. There's a reason why the Hubble Space Telescope has a large mirror and other ground-based telescopes are measured in meters, not millimeters or feet even. Larger aperture gathers more light, and that allows us to see dimmer objects and increases the resolution of the optical instrument. But let's not get too far into the weeds. We'll look at these three similarly sized telescopes to understand magnification first. To determine magnification of a telescope, we perform a simple calculation. Take the focal length of the telescope in millimeters and divide that number by the focal length of the eyepiece you are using. So for example, let's take our three telescopes and look at each, assuming a 20 millimeter focal length eyepiece. This 76 millimeter refractor has a 1200 millimeter focal length. So if we divide that by a 20 millimeter eyepiece, the magnification is 60 times. For our shorter refractor, its focal length is about 600 millimeters. So dividing that by 20 millimeter eyepiece, we get 30 times. And for a short, stubby little reflector like this one, it's got a focal length of just 300 millimeters. So dividing it by 20 millimeters, we get just 15 times magnification. And think about this for a moment. If we change to a 10 millimeter eyepiece, we see the change in magnification for each, but the ratio of magnification doesn't change among the telescopes. We'll talk about those ratios in a moment. But first, how does each telescope's length alter what we can see in each telescope differently? Well, it actually changes it rather substantially. Look at this. In the long refractor, we would see only this much of the well-known Pleiades star cluster. It's not very much. The field of view is only 3/4 of a degree, and the Pleiades is much larger than that. Moving to our mid-sized refractor, we can see quite a bit more, just barely fitting the entire cluster in the field of view. But the reflector is where we can see far more. Look at how this view frames the cluster nicely. So the lower magnification and shorter focal length with its wider field of view can actually help us see more. How does that work? Well, it works by understanding a bit about the focal ratios. Remember, all of those telescopes were nearly the same aperture but different lengths. This time, if we divide the focal length by the aperture or diameter across the mirror or lens, we arrive at some different numbers, but these are fixed numbers for every telescope and do not change. That long refractor is nearly 16 to 1 as we divide 1200 millimeters into the aperture of 76 millimeters and arrive at 15.8 for an F ratio, or about F16. Quite a long focal ratio telescope. The mid-length refractor is a shorter F ratio. 600 millimeters divided by 70 millimeters is f8.5. And the short little refractor has the shortest focal length of all, 300 divided by 76 is 3.9, or close to f4. F3 to f5s are definitely short F ratio telescopes. So the longer F ratio telescopes provide more magnification with the same eyepiece, but less field of view. This makes it easier to get high magnification for planets, for example, but harder to see wide field views like the Pleiades. Middle ones can still provide fairly high magnification, decent fields of view as well, and it's no wonder that many F7 to F10 instruments are quite popular. And short focal length telescopes provide the widest fields of view, but the least magnification using the same focal length eyepiece. Though in larger apertures, the focal ratio tends to get faster so that tube lengths do not become unwieldy and difficult to use or mount. Of course, we can get more magnification with shorter eyepiece focal lengths or by using Barlow lenses, and wider fields of view using other types of eyepieces, but see videos 3 and 5 for more information on those topics. So that is a quick look at magnification and focal ratios. Now let's look at some other aspects of telescopes. In part 3 of this series, I'll talk about various types of eyepieces. To see what's up in the night sky, check out the weekly night sky videos at eyesonthesky.com. Thanks for watching. I hope that has provided you with a good overview of magnification and focal ratio. Keep your eyes on the sky and your outdoor lights aimed down so we can all see what's up.